Good afternoon, dear students. In today's class and the previous class, we have discussed the working functionality of a differential amplifier with differential input, okay, and the gain was considered. And in today's class, we will discuss the common mode gain, and in particular, the common mode rejection ratio as well. Okay, the figure over here shows the circuit diagram of the differential amplifier, okay, which is biased with a current source having an output resistance. Let me consider it as a RSS. Now we are going to give a input voltage to both the transistors Q1 and Q2, both the transistors Q1 and Q2, okay, and it is biased at the DC voltage VCM, okay, and VICM is the incremental AC voltages which is applied to both the transistors. So this is a consideration we need to remember. The common mode signal can be represented as a noise or interference that can be picked up at the input, which is undesirable property. Okay, now let us check out how much of VICM makes its way to the output of the amplifier. Okay, you have an amplifier where output is taken at the drain, you know that, okay, at both the drains, and to what extent this VICM input is getting sent to the output side. Okay, what is the change in the circuit? You have a presence of RSS. Okay, the bias current of Q1 and Q2. Okay, the bias current will be more than I by 2 because there is a existence. The current will be determined by VICM, VCM and the RSS. Whenever you have the RSS is the output resistance of the current source. When RSS is large, the additional current in each of transistor will be small because the current flowing, the supply current would be very less. Okay, we can assume still that Q1 and Q2 operate at bias current 50% of I, but the effect of RSS on the differential gain will develop as a virtual ground on the common source terminal, resulting there is a zero signal. The current through RSS hence has no effect on the differential gain. Okay. Now, the response of the differential amplifier for this common mode input voltage, we need to analyze the circuit. What is the change for the, whenever you include RSS, what is the change corresponding to the including the RS for the circuit? In the circuit, we replace each of VDD and VSS with the short circuit, and current source I is open circuit for analysis. Okay. For analysis purpose, we need to consider the bias voltages which is connected or the power supply to be made equal to zero, and the current source which is present is open circuit. And let us consider that current flowing through the Q1 transistor as I, and similar way current flowing through the Q2 is also I. So therefore, the meeting point is at this point, though the current flowing through the RSS will be the 2 times of I, that is 2I. Okay, now if I suppose write the the T model with and neglecting R naught, the resulting equivalent is shown is here. So we have to represent the T model based on that. If I write VICM is a voltage, KCL at figure C. Okay, you have figure C. For that figure C, if I apply KCL, so we will get, so this is a T model. You have a T model for the previous circuit. Apply KCL at this point. Okay. The T model for the transistor, T model for the transistor already existed, RD, and this is RSS. At a required point, if I apply KCL, okay, KVL to the loop 1, VICM is equal to I by GM plus 2 times I into RSS. From this I can be determined, which is equal to the applied voltage VICM divided by the sum. How do you find the current? I is equal to voltage applied divided by sum of resistance if it is present, whatever you have. In this case, 1 by GM I to RSS will come in series. The voltage is current is determined. Okay, the voltage is drain would be V out 1, V out 2 will be equal to minus RD into I. But I is what? VICM divided by 1 by GM plus 2 RSS. So therefore, V out 1 will be equal to V out 2 equal to minus RD by 1 by GM plus 2 RSS into VICM. Okay. but both voltages VO1 and VO2 will be corrupted by the common mode signal VICM and will be given by VO1 by VICM is equal to minus RD by RSS. Suppose the condition is simplified when 1/2 RSS is very much larger than the 1/gm. So the concept is very simple. You need to apply a KVL for this loop by considering the T model for the circuit and write down the equation for VO1 by VICM. Okay, that is carried out by taking an expression for first I in terms of VICM. So this is a simple KVL rule, and from making use of this, I get output voltage is equal to minus RD into I because the current is moving downwards. Okay, current is moving downwards, so therefore I need to take it as negative. And then finally I got an expression for the Vout by VICM. Now the output voltage VOD, the differential voltage will be zero because you will get the same voltage at both the output terminals of the transistor. So therefore VOD will be zero. What is the indication here? It rejects the common mode signal for a matched transistor. For an unbalanced condition or a not matched transistor, the condition is not possible. So therefore, it cannot reject the common mode signal. The condition is, I repeat, the condition is whenever the transistor Q1 and Q2 are matched, it rejects the, what it rejects, it rejects the common signal. But when the condition is it is not a matched or unbalanced transistor, it has not been matched, or will never reject. So two half circuits of the differential amplifier for common mode analysis is shown here. So the circuit is split up into two. Circuit is split up into two half circuit where you have Q1 RD, Q2 RD, and the resistance 2 RSS. Okay. The half circuit current carries a current. What we are trying to say is the explanation for whatever equations which I have discussed now. I is equal to VICM divided by 1/gm plus. Either you go for T model or you go for the half circuit concept. Both will yield to the same results. Therefore, and the voltage Vs is RSS into I. So this is a condition where you get a voltage at this point is zero. So this is each of the common circuit simplifying. I can write the half circuit concept and write down this point as a ground. Due to the RSS, it will develop a virtual ground. Observe here, it is developing a virtual ground. So since it is developing a virtual ground, I can analyze the circuit either by going with half circuit or considering the T model. So in the T model as well, if I consider what is the effect of this, what is the effect of this? This is acting like a ground point. This is acting like a ground point. Okay, that is being discussed over here. Now, what if when the transistors are matched, but the RD is not matched, the connection condition, suppose when transistors are not matched, it will lead to carryover of the common mode signal. The common mode signals in general will never be rejected. But whenever you have a condition saying that the RD is mismatched with a parameter delta RD. So RD is equal to RD plus delta RD. Now if that condition is incorporated, you can write VOUT1 is equal to VDD minus ID into RD. This is a known thing. But when VDD is zero for this condition for analysis, RD is changed to be RD plus delta RD over here. Okay. RD plus delta RD it is considered. So therefore, you have the equation for VOUT1 and VOUT2 and write down an expression simplifying. What is the change you need to observe over here? VOD minus 2 delta RD by 2 RSS into VICM. So VOD by VICM. So the expression for common mode gain when the resistance are not matched. Okay. So this can also be expressed in terms of RD into 2 RSS. Then additional term delta RD. Okay, an additional term, you are going to get delta RD by RD. Okay, this equation can be also be expressed by multiplying and subtracting. You can express this equation. So mismatch in the drain resistance causes the differential amplifier to have a finite common mode gain. Okay, usually common mode gain would be zero. In this case, you have finite common mode gain when you have the differential amplifier having not the mismatched resistance. Okay, either when you have a transistors mismatch also, that it will carry out some portion of the current, some portion of the common mode signal. But in case of a resistors, it is also mismatch. Now, if I have a common mode gain and I have a common mode differential mode gain, I can always express the common mode rejection ratio as AD by ACM, which is a 2GM RSS divided by delta RD by RD, to obtain CMRR, common mode rejection, and bias current source with high output resistance should be there. Effect of GM on the common mode gain, the next concept. After being discussing so many things relevant to the common mode gain, we will get the same output voltage for the common mode signal if the transistors are matched properly. Suppose if the transistors are not matched, the words are repeatedly, I'm been quoting out, like saying that it will, when transistors are not matched, the common mode signal will be carried away to the output side and disturbs the scenario of working. Whenever the resistance are not matched, what is the gain we have seen? Now, effect of GM, what does you mean by GM? GM is a transconductance. Okay, let GM1 be the transconductance for the first transistor and GM2 be the transconductance of the second transistor, and change in the mismatch can be different, like half of delta GM, half of delta GM. Okay, or I can say that change in the differential gain, transconductance can be solved by taking this simultaneous equation, and I can denote it as delta GM. Okay, so circuit has no large symmetry. We cannot apply the common mode half circuit. We represent by means of T model. When the circuit is not observed, when it is not symmetric, you have to go by this technique. Write down the circuit diagram and write down the corresponding T model. For this is a known thing. Delta R naught for this circuit is neglected. R naught for this circuit is also neglected. Current flowing through this, let me call it as I1. Current flowing through this is called as I2, and therefore the current flowing through RSS will be 2 times R, I1 plus I2. Okay. If I1 and I2 are same, it is twice of I1. So we say that it is not having a larger symmetric. We cannot apply the common half circuit concept. Half circuit concept is mainly used for simplification. Just by considering that and observing the circuitry itself, we can define the gain for a differential amplifier, or you can obtain the gain for the differential amplifier. Now in this case, the symmetric is not being observed, so therefore we are not analyzing with the half circuit. This is a major difference you need to understand. So for the T model considered equivalent circuit, if I write an equation for I1 and I2, okay, so voltage VICM is nothing but the voltage between gate and source. Gate is at a voltage of source is at a voltage of VS, and gate is at a certain potential VSM. The difference between the voltage is VICM minus VS. Now the current I is nothing but the resistance into the current. Okay, if you write these two currents are same, how we need to prove here? Okay, how I1 into 1 by GM is equal to I2 into 1 by GM. So this is an equivalent circuit if I consider for analysis. Okay, VICM is an input voltage, and this is a 1 by GM resistance, and RS is a included resistance. To the Q2 transistor, you will write. Now, VICM, applying KVL to loop 1, VICM minus VGS minus VS equal to 0. Okay, consider loop 2, VICM into minus I2 into 1 by GM2 into minus VS is equal to 0. So equating both, I tend to get I1 into 1 by GM is equal to I2 into 1 by GM2. Okay, and we saw that I1 plus I2 is as what is that? If I take I1 plus I2 is 0, I2 is nothing but I1 into 1 by GM. Okay, replacing I2 in terms of I1. So replacing I2 in terms of I1, I can write and substitute for equation and write I1 plus I2 is equal to I1 into 1 plus GM1 2 by GM1. Now what is the final conclusion? When the voltage, now the voltage between the gates of Q1 and ground is equal to VICM. Applying KVL. So circuit involves a rigorous analysis of KVL and KCL. Okay. And applying KVL to this loop one, VICM minus I1 GM1 into I1 plus I2. Both the currents are there. So equating that to zero and simplifying VICM and expressing what is the equation for this, like taking I1 as common, I10 2 plus 1 by GM1 plus 1 plus GM2 by GM1 into RSS. Okay. So to obtain I1 in terms of VICM, as I1 is nothing but GM1 into VICM divided by 1 plus GM1 plus GM2 into RSS. The simplification is written onto this. This is the equation we had got. Okay. Taking towards left hand side. So, and expressing for I1. So, similarly, I can express I2 as GM2 into VICM divided by 1 GM1 plus GM2 into RSS. Now, the voltages at the terminals are Vout1 is equal to minus I1 RD. So, the output voltage at the second transistor is Vout2 is equal to minus I2 into RD. So, I get the equation. Now, the concept here is after being obtaining Vout1 and Vout2 in terms of VICM, okay, you can ask what we are trying to do with so much rigorous analysis is obtaining an equation for output voltage in terms of the common mode gain when the for the considered condition. Now VOD is VOUT2 minus VOUT1 and simplifying this you get, you have both the terms GM1 and GM2. On GM1 and GM2 if you incorporate this, I can write it as a delta GM and write VOD is equal to delta GM RD divided by 1 plus 2 GM RSS. Okay. So if I simplify, I tend to get this equation. So I tend to get this equation and if you can observe, Vout1 into delta GM. Okay. Kindly adjust. This is a rotated one. Okay. When ACM is equal to RD by RSS into delta GM by 2 GM. Okay. Our common mode corresponding common mode gain is also rejection ratio is have been written. Okay. So what we have derived is a condition for the common mode gain when the resistors are mismatched and the transistors are not matched properly. Okay. Now, after being discussed different concepts related to, after being discussed with different concepts related to, you have the concept of the differential amplifier with active load. So replacing the resistance RD, you can write down with the active load. This is a differential to single ended conversion, how you are going to do. So illustrate simple basic approach for differential to single ended, where RD is replaced with this for this transistor. It consists of ignoring the drain currents of Q1. Its resistance is removed, taking the output only at Q2. You would say that the output is taken at only the Q2 transistor. Okay. So therefore, you can say the differential to single ended. What is the drawback? We lose a factor of 2 dB or 6, to factor 2 or 6 dB. Okay. As a result of wasting the drain current of Q1. A much better approach. This is not a better approach. A much better approach is using the current mirror. Okay. So using a current mirror, you can do this. So you have a transistor Q1 and Q2. This is a very important thing for differential amplifier with a current mirror. Okay. A concept here later in the earlier classes we had discussed, RD of the both Q1 and Q2 transistor carries the same current. Therefore, we are using a PMOS current mirror here. Okay. PMOS current mirror. So you have additional two transistor Q3 and Q4, and for this Q3 and Q4, the corresponding voltages like VGS1 and VGS2 or VGS3, whatever it is written, output, the current carrying through this transistor Q1 is I by 2, the current carrying through this Q2 is also I by 2, Q1 is also I by 2, the same current is flowing through Q3 and Q4, so that rather than being using a resistor, I'm going for the active load, that is a current mirror. The quiescent state with two input terminals connected to DC voltage equal to the common mode equilibrium in case zero. So as shown, the bias current divides equally, that is what I have told, equally. So that current is mirrored to Q4 transistor. Q4 and Q3 is a mirror pair. It should be matched properly. And only thing is, both should be drain voltage will keep track of the drain voltage will track the voltage. The current mirror is considered over here for analysis. The circuit, the same circuit is considered with the voltage, bias voltage source is maintained at zero. That is, the VDD is connected to zero. For small signal, the DC supply should be removed and the current source, whatever it is there, it should be removed. A virtual ground will eventually exist at the two source of Q1 and Q2. So therefore, the drain current of Q1 is IGM into VID by 2. And transistor 2 will conduct in opposite way if Q1 is increasing current and Q2 will be in the decreasing manner. So when I take output at the, both currents will be equal to 2I. So therefore, Vout will be equal to 2I into R. So this is a equation. So differential gain for this common mode, so I want to write. So let us consider R0 into account and obtain expression for differential gain is given by Vout by VID. So because the circuit is not symmetrical, as virtual ground will not develop at the common source terminal, will not able to use the differential half circuit concept. I repeat, half circuit concept can only be applicable or applied only you have a symmetrical nature of circuit. Okay, so therefore Vout is equal to GM VID into R0. So Vout by VID is given nothing but the gain GM into RT. So how do you determine GM? Okay, GM RD is a GM is a current source VID. So this is a equivalent circuit for a differential gain. Now for this GM, if I want to determine short circuited, we have short circuited the output to the ground in order to find GM. So GM is given by I0 by VID. So original circuit is using current mirror. So for this circuit, if I write an equivalent circuit in terms of individual output resistances, individual output resistance or finite output resistance of Q1 is denoted by R01, Q2 is denoted by R02, similarly for Q4 is R04 and Q3 is R03. Okay, and write down the circuit. This circuit can be rewritten as this, because you have 1 by GM and R03 will come into parallel for a T model. Similarly for this, because only thing here is you need to consider, so whatever R01 is written. Okay, let us consider figure B. We replaced upper part of the virtual ground with the equivalent circuit, that is what is told. Output voltage is taken at the load, okay, upper part, it is for the PMOS load. So therefore VG3 is nothing but VDD minus IDRD. VDD is given to be 0. ID1 is equal to GM1 VID by 2. So RD resistance is nothing but 1 by GM3 parallel R03 parallel R01. So VG3 is nothing but substituting an equation for whatever ID, you get this equations. So one, you need to note the symmetry. If you have VG3 and VG4 will be equal. Since VG4 is a short circuit, if you find VG3, it is sufficient. Okay, so therefore, what is VG3? The next thing, how do you find VG3? VG3 is nothing but minus GM VID into by GM3 parallel R03 parallel R01. So if this condition is imposed, if the resistance are very large, I can write VG3 is equal to minus GM1 by GM3 into VID. So output voltage, output current is nothing but I0 KCL at Y. In the figure, you have denote a terminal called Y. So denote a terminal called Y and apply KCL at this stage. So apply KCL at this stage. So what is that? Equation says that I0 is equal to minus GM4 into VG3 plus GM2 into VID by 2. So we have an equation for GM3. Okay, substituting that and simplifying, I get I out is equal to GM VID, or GM is equal to I out by VID as an expression. So short circuit transconductance of the circuit will be equal to GM of each of the two transistor of the differential pair. Now, what is the output resistance? What is the output resistance? So we R0 is nothing but Vx by Ix. Okay. So for that, this is a circuit to find the output resistance. It is denoted the path, how you have the path flow of current, how the current is flowing, the Ix, because you are including current, Vx voltage source at the output terminal, which carries a current. This is a current flow of Ix. Okay. So you have current flow I entering into Q2, that is extensively given, and Ix is nothing but Vx by R02. R02 is the output resistance. The load resistance of Q1 is given to be 1 by GM3 parallel R03, which is equal to 1 by GM3. I can approximate. So the input resistance of common gate, if I consider this as a transistor, it is acting like a common gate, I can write Rin is equal to 1 by GM. Now, the Q2 is in common gate configuration. How RO2 is, it is a already derived equation from the analysis which has been told in the earlier sessions. So therefore, R02 is equal to 2R0 when you have this terms are very small when you compare for this. So therefore, finally, Vx by Ix is equal to R02 parallel R04. So set of equations is being derived. So next, if you consider the differential gain, Vout by VID, which is equal to GM into R0. R0 is R02 parallel R04. If they are equal, VID is equal to A0 by 2. So 50% of the. What we are trying to do here is for an active load, a differential gain, common mode gain, the output impedance, and other parameters are determined. So using KVL equation, what is the must? Writing the equivalent circuit, considering what are the parameters to be considered, and write down the output equations, and correspondingly the equivalent circuits are very much important here to find out the gains. So this is the equivalent circuit for the current mirror. The differential amplifier with current mirror. Okay, Q1 and Q2 with a load RSS considered. The same analysis, whatever we have done without RSS and with RSS, if you consider what is the change in the equation and what are the equations related to it, the analysis is quite similar to whatever we already discussed.